If you view the 61st Annual Grammy Awards, you would have witnessed Alicia Keys' ode to the legendary Hazel Scott. Hazel Scott wowed the world with her sultry style, audacious personality, star power, and undeniable musical talent, but don't just take my word for it. She was not only a phenomenal pianist, but broke many racial barriers for black musicians and actors. Hazel Dorothy Scott was born in Port of Spain on June 11, 1920. She became interested in the piano at the early age of 3. Although her mother, Alma Long Scott, was a classically trained pianist, Hazel learned how to play the piano by ear. Once her mother tuned in on how talented Hazel was, she forfeited her musical career to focus on her daughters. Hazel's dad started out in the house, but later left the family. Hazel, her mother, and grandmother later migrated to the United States, ending up in Harlem, New York. To help make ends meet, she taught herself the saxophone and in the 1930s joined the Little Hardin Armstrong Orchestra.
For free on the doorstep, just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear the pitter-patter and the happy beat as you're stepping? Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street.
As a child, Hazel earned a scholarship from Juilliard School of Music to receive private lessons. Hazel was not a shy gal and was very outgoing. Her colorful personality led her to host a radio show as a teenager. Although she worked while attending school, she managed it well and graduated high school with honors. Shortly after graduation, she landed a Broadway role in Sing Out the News. She also recorded a commercial entitled Bach to Boogie that broke sales records nationwide. Responsible with her celebrity status, she refused to play for segregated audiences. When she entered Hollywood, she changed the dynamics of how black actors were treated. Her demands involved black actors no longer sporting maid and servant clothing. She further demanded that her name appear in the credits. She played in several movies but hit the peak in her acting career in the movie The Heat's On. On the movie set, she openly expressed her disdain for black actresses' wardrobe and said no woman would want to see her sweetheart off to war wearing a dirty apron. To enforce this change, she staged a 3-day strike that in turn changed the wardrobe of the black cast. In 1945, Hazel Scott married Harlem preacher politician Adam Clayton and later conceived her son, Adam Clayton III. In 1950, she became the first black performer to host a nationally syndicated television show entitled The Hazel Scott Show. Unfortunately, shortly after, she was suspected as a communist due to her affiliation with the Cafe Society and her civil rights efforts. Against her husband's wishes, she voluntarily appeared before the Communist Committee. After a series of questions, she replied, "May I end with one request, and that is that your committee protect those Americans who have honestly, wholesomely, and unselfishly tried to protect this country and make the guarantees in our Constitution live. The actors, musicians, Artists, composers, and all of the men and women of the arts are eager and anxious to help, to serve. Our country needs us more today than ever before. We should not be written off by the vicious slanders of little and petty men. Although entertainers applauded her courage, the government severed her career. Her show was canceled and her bookings drastically decreased. Concurrent to this event, her marriage fell apart and she divorced her husband. After these events, she moved to Paris, where she lived there for 10 years. Within those 10 years, she remarried to Ezio Bedin. Upon her return to America, music had transitioned to rhythm and blues, and she was no longer a commodity in the music industry. In October 1981, Hazel Scott died of pancreatic cancer. We thank Hazel for her courageous endeavors and her breaking barriers in Hollywood for us future generations. ¶¶